Mr. Speaker, without a deliberate and strategic determination to address the productivity challenges in the agricultural sector and reverse the decline in our exports through value addition, our third thematic goal of accelerating inclusive growth for economic transformation will not be achieved. A sustainable economic transformation strategy must, at the initial stage, embrace sectors in which the majority of our people derive their livelihood. Agriculture is best positioned to open up opportunities across the country and sustain equitable development and prosperity. This will largely depend on unlocking the potential of the sector through active participation of the private sector through value chain. The expansion of agricultural output will also increase food supplies, reduce food prices, and bring down the cost of living, create employment, and promote overall rural development. Through this budget, we are rolling out a model farm covering 10,000 acres as part of 1 million acre irrigation project at Galana Ranch. Concurrently, we are engaging with financial institutions and development partners to establish an agribusiness fund, which the private sector can access in order to fast-track implementation of 1 million acre irrigation project and agricultural transformation ventures throughout the country. The financial institutions have indicated willingness to leverage government's seed capital by a scale of 1 to 10. Mr. Speaker, to ensure full realization of food security and lower food prices, I am allocating 9.5 billion Kenya shillings towards the ongoing irrigation projects. This will include 3.5 billion allocated to the Galana irrigation project, 3 billion for input subsidy, including fertilizer, 2.7 billion for strategic grain reserves, 1 billion for fisheries development, 700 million for the revival of Kenya Meat Commission. In order to create more employment opportunities in the sector, I have allocated 300 million for the revival of the pyrethrum sector and another 300 million for establishment of free disease zones. Mr. Speaker, considering the challenges of drought and floods we continue to face as a country, we have once again prioritized flood control and water harvesting. In this regard, therefore, I have allocated 8.2 billion for construction of water ponds and dams, 4.1 billion for water supply and sanitation, and 1.5 billion for environmental protection, conservation, and management. I have also provided 500 million for completion of multipurpose dams that were started under the economic stimulus program.